If you're feeling overwhelmed with all the to-dos on your list, with all the roles you have to play in your life, and if you're in the meetings industry, I'm guessing you're feeling pretty overwhelmed. Well, stick around. I'm going to share how I increase my productivity and how I manage my time as it relates to each individual role. Everyone, it's Leanne from leannecalderwood.com, and every now and again I like to do a blog post that speaks to one of my favorite books. It's called The Five Choices, the Path to Extraordinary Productivity, put out by some experts over at the Franklin Covey Company. And I've done a blog post, an introductory blog post and video quite a while back about the book as a whole, and you can find that video here. But today I'm focusing on a chapter that talks about the different roles that we play in our lives. Because as much as we want to be productive in our work role, it's not only our work role that we're trying to be productive at, we're also trying to be productive when it comes to being a homemaker, being a roommate, being a wife, a parent, a hockey team manager, pick me. All of these things, we need to be at our optimal best. And when we're running low of energy or we're feeling like all of our to-dos are scattered, we're not doing a good job at any of them. So I'm going to outline some things that should help all of us kind of get back on track with each of the roles in our lives, so that when we do spend time in each individual role, we're actually maximizing the time that we're there, we're impacting the people that we're interacting with, and we're doing more with our productivity. So are you ready to do this with me? Here we go. So the first thing we do is we actually need to define all the roles that we have in our lives. And it could be a multitude of things. I listed off a few earlier, being wife and parent, but it could also be colleague. It could be mentor. It could be as a team leader. If you're DOS, that's definitely a role. If you're a sales manager, that's certainly a role. So all of these things you need to brainstorm and put on a list of the different roles that you're going to play in your life. Now, what you're going to do with each individual role is define what success looks like in that role. So, for example, as a site selection professional or as a hotel sales manager, success is going to look like when clients are happy and you've done your absolute best to advocate for them. So that's what success looks like. And you might even want to assign some SMART goals to this success. So how happy are they with you? How many programs did you book this past year that you would see success as a hotel sales manager or as a site selection professional? So that's what I want you to do first, is go through each and every role and define what success looks like for you in that role. Now that you've defined success in each role, take an honest look at how you're performing so far. So it's a self-assessment time. You're looking at each role and the success indicator, and now you're going to grade yourself 1 out of 1 to 10 on how you're doing in that role. This is now going to help us in crafting statements to get us up to snuff in that particular role. So be honest with yourself. If you feel you're only doing a 3 out of 10, that is okay. That means we have some more work to do in the next step. But make sure you honestly assess how you're doing in each individual role. Now that you've assessed how you're doing in each role, it's time to craft a role statement. This is the fun part. This is where you can get creative and play with words and figure out what your role statement is for each particular role. So your role statement is going to start off with as a wife or as a hotel sales manager. You're going to follow it up with, I will create trust relationships with my clients, or I will act as my client's best advocate in negotiating a contract with my hotel. After your I will statement, it's followed by the action statement. I will create trust relationships with my clients by asking them about their program's goals and objectives each time. Something simple like that. And you can make that action statement as long or as short as you want, because now we're going to follow it up with the final step and create tangible things that we can do to make sure that you are completing your role statement. So as a hotel sales manager, I am going to advocate for my clients by asking them what they need from their programs. And these are the steps that I'm going to follow to make sure that I can complete that entire statement. Does that make sense? So I've elaborated this a little bit more in my blog post, and you can find a link to my blog post below this video as well. When you're done reading the blog post, I encourage you to sign up for my resource, How to Get a Meeting Planner's Attention. And you can also find that in the link above here. And those are some very quick tips and tricks on how to get you on the right track with building trust relationships with your clients. And it also adds you to my newsletter, which does not suck. So each week I give out a newsletter, which actually goes a little bit further into this blog post and video, but then also has some resources that you can't find anywhere else on my website. So make sure that you tap into the weekly newsletter. Thank you for watching today's video, and I wish you all the success as you go through this exercise in identifying your roles, crafting strong role statements, and of course, acting on those to-do list items to get you closer to perfection in each individual role. I hope you have a great week, and we'll see you next time. Bye for now.